Love Yourself. This is an electric guitar song. It's not really an acoustic song. You can play it on acoustic guitar, but I don't think it has the same vibe. If you don't have an electric, then do it on acoustic. If it's not practical for you to play it on electric when you're performing it, then do it on acoustic. But if there's any way you can do it on electric, do it on electric. We do not use a pick in this song. It's going to be totally finger style. So you're basically going to be using what I call the claw, which is thumb, index, middle. I'm going to give you the chord list first. We're in the key of E major. No capo. No capo. No capo. The way the song is played, it's going to start out with E. Going to go to the B chord with D sharp in the bass. And it's going to go to C sharp minor. Then it's going to go up to F sharp minor. Think that. Think F sharp minor. E. Then B with the D sharp in the bass. Now the B with the D sharp in the bass is the exact same fingering as the other two, the C sharp minor and the F sharp. That's because it's an inverted chord, meaning that the D sharp is part of a B major chord, but it's in the bass of the chord. So the chord doesn't have B in the bass, it has D sharp. And what that does is produces a really cool descending bass line. So I recommend you learn that first. So I'm on the 7th fret, 5th, these are all on the 5th string. And I'm using my first finger because that's what you're going to be using in the chord. So I have 7th fret, 6th fret, 4th. The other riff is 9th fret, 7th, 6th. So if I go 9, 7, 6. That's it. That's your riff. Now, let's put the top of the chord on. The E major, you're going to use your 3rd and 4th finger on strings 3 and 2. Now, let's just do that part of the chord. So, let's split this between bass and top. So, what I did, I have 2 fingers on the 9th fret. My 3rd and 4th. My ring finger, pinky. I'm striking with my index and middle. Now, when I go to the 2nd chord, my 3rd finger is going to slide down with my pinky, and then I'm going to replace my pinky with my 2nd finger down a fret. So it's going to be the 8th fret and the 7th fret. That's the top of the B chord that we're playing right now. So we have, and then we go down 2 more frets to 5th position. Well, really it's going to be 4th position once we add the bass. And we have that same shape. So go back and forth. So very similar to learning a piano piece one hand at a time, right hand and then left hand. Basically, we're splitting the part so that you can see what's happening. So bass. Now let's put the tops on. Oh, there it is, both together. Now notice, the first chord, every time he comes to this E chord in this section of the piece, he slides into it. I've seen a couple of tutorials where they've left that out. This is pretty important. Now the click I'm making, there's only one way to get the sound on this song, is with an electric guitar clicking onto the pickup. The pickup is the area, obviously, that produces a sound from your strings. So when you come down on the pickup, it makes a certain kind of sound that acoustic guitar doesn't make. It's more of a... That's it. Now, I mentioned the other way to finger this with the right hand. You could go thumb, index, middle, and then hook that 2nd string like this. You know how we're getting this doubled sound? And then a click, so it's bass and chord at the same time, and then another melody, which is a single note. You could go striking thumb, index, middle, and then hit that 2nd string again with your 2nd finger, or you can strike and then come under with your ring finger. Depends on how brave you want to be. The second way is harder, of course. But the articulation is more classical-like, something that Dan Cantor would do, more of a classical fingering right-hand technique. Feel free to do that. So once again, I hook underneath, hook under. Now, let's go to the second part. We're going to go to F sharp minor ninth position, minor form, to E, which was our first chord, and then that B chord with D sharp and a bass, which was originally our second chord, now it's our last chord. You can see this song is very melodic in terms of the chords. It's voice leading, chord movement, very simple chords, however, done very well, done in kind of a unique way, where we're splitting, we're not playing these giant chords. Let's do the second section real quick. This is basically power chords. I'm just strumming with my right hand finger now. C sharp minor power chord. And feel free to go ahead and make the whole bar chord because later on you're going to hear it. It's C sharp, A, E major. Again, C sharp, E major. Now it switches here. Does the E, A, right at the end of the chorus, he plays the E major and then this A2 chord, because I hear the B string ringing. From here on out, we go back into another verse and it pretty much repeats the material we've already done. So the best way to get back up to that chord, real quick, this is the last thing I'll talk to you about. That's it, guys. That's pretty much the whole song. I don't want to beat it to death because it's really not that difficult, and I think you won't have a hard time with it.